The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I am Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back to my channel, and this is a professional tip. Now, we are talking about how you are damaging your brain, how you can actually enhance your mind power, your brain, and actually prevent brain memory problems even later in your life. Most importantly, this video is important for people who actually are ignoring their brains, because many people don't even realize that brain is being ignored until and unless they will actually have a symptom like say memory loss, or say numbness or tingling sensation, weakness in some part, the loss of coordination after a certain age, and then they realize, okay, the brain was important, I've been ignoring it. So this is the story of every single one of us, right? Many people do this, and we know that brain is a very vital, important organ. Every single function of our body is coordinated by the brain. No matter if it is your thoughts, your emotions, your movement, your coordination, something you want to do, something you are saying, something you're watching, interpreting, right? Every single logic is, calibrated inside your brain, and every single memory is stored inside your brain, which you can fetch out, short-term, long-term memory. That's so complicated. So many synapses, so many neurons, so many firing inside the brain and the nervous system. So obviously it needs to be taken care of. So how you can take care of it, how you are damaging it? Damage, number one reasons are listed here. Let's start discussing. The number one reason why you are damaging your brain is, and how you can take care of it, the number one reason is sleep. Lack of sleep is the biggest problem, because the best thing which you can give, the best care which you can give to your brain is by shutting it down. It's shutting it down and letting it reboot, relax, rest for hours, good 7 to 9 hours. Not 3, not 4, no 5 or 6. 7 to 9 hours of sleep is important for your brain health in a long time, right? Once in a while, it's okay not to sleep. Once in a while, it's okay to sleep less. But if it is a regular habit, you are damaging your brain and you are lacking the most important thing, because during this sleep, your brain actually clears out the beta amyloid proteins which are deposited inside the brain. And these are the proteins which are responsible for Alzheimer's disease, memory loss, these kind of memory and neural problems, right, later in life. So if you don't sleep chronically, you will have these problems more earlier, and more you'll be more likely that you'll have these problems later. So sleeping is very important. What you can do, number one, take time, right? Sometimes you have to give away something to achieve something. Number one thing is you have to give away, you have to have a digital kind of something which you have to do is put away all your digital mobiles or any kind of digital things at least half to 1 hour before you sleep, and you have to dim or switch off all the lights and do not try to engage in any other thoughts. If you have any worries, any other thoughts which actually do not let you sleep, just take a paper, pen or a diary and write it down. You can get back to that thought tomorrow, and believe me, this is a very small thing, but it works, because your mind, your subconscious mind knows that it's been written, so it's not going anywhere. You can get back to it and you're not going to do anything about it tonight, so you can actually sleep, and you can sleep well. So that's one of the few things which you can do to sleep well, and try to sleep for at least 7 to 9 hours. 7 to 9 hours is very important. So this is the number one thing which you can do to actually keep your brain healthy. The second biggest thing which you can do is exercise. Regular exercise, especially your legs, are very important because the legs are the second heart. It pumps the blood up, and the more you exercise your legs, the more your heart will actually pump blood into your brain. And your brain, obviously, blood carries the nutrient, blood carries away the toxin. So blood is the only source of all the nutrition to your brain. So more blood is good. Right, so that's why exercise is good. Increases the blood flow as well as it relaxes your brain, helps in the better functioning of your brain. So exercise is the second thing. Third biggest thing is meditation. You need to relax your mind for at least 5 to 10 minutes. Concentrate on something. Right, it might be some religious meditation, non-religious meditation, it's up to you, but meditation is important. Concentrating on something is very important for at least 5-10 minutes. Right, then third thing is meditation. Fourth is your diet. Diet is a big factor here, because it's been seen that people who eat a lot of junk food have more chances of strokes and brain disorders than people who eat healthy. A healthy diet obviously protects you. Then second thing which is important is you have to manage your weight and fat percentage. If your BMI is less than 25, you have much less chances of all these risks of brain strokes or any brain disorders. You have less chances of Alzheimer's in future. Then what you can do, obviously you have to manage your weight. For that, a lot of videos are there on my channel. And what you can add into your diet, number one is you can add omega-3s. Omega-3 fatty acids are the most important thing which you can add for your brain. Second thing which you can add are dark chocolates. Yes, dark chocolate or a little bit of caffeine or coffee or chai, tea is good for your brain once or twice maximum. If it increases more than that, it can cause insomnia, decreases your sleep, and that's why you can have more problems in future. So one or two is good. Coffee or tea, actually caffeine protects your liver and the brain as well. It triggers, it stimulates your brain. So timing is important. So you have to do these stimulants before doing any mind work, before exercise, right? That is important. So you can take coffee, you can take dark chocolate, and you can take something called as a mind diet. That is MIND diet. Yes, we have already made a video on DASH dash diet in our main channel, which you can watch. So mind diet is basically a combination of dash diet and Mediterranean diet, in which the more emphasis has been given to berries and leaves, leafy vegetables, right? So more emphasis on that. I'll make a different video on that, but you can know that if you watch my video on dash diet, then emphasize more on berries and leaves, then it becomes mind diet. Then this is the fourth big thing. The fifth big thing which you can do for your brain is your heart. You have to keep your heart healthy, because the heart basically has a direct communication with the brain. If there is a problem in the heart, if your blood pressure is high, if you have any kind of clots or plaques or coronary artery disease, you have more chances of stroke. You have more chances of brain disorder. If you have high cholesterol, you have heart disorder, you have brain disease, you will have some kind of brain problem. Diabetes, again, increases the risk factor. So sugar, diabetes, blood pressure, cholesterol, heart disease, stroke, all are related. You have to manage these metabolic syndromes, right? You have to manage this problem as well. And you have to avoid this, reduce your weight, increase your activity, healthy diet. The whole process, it cannot be without one thing or the other. A car has to have four wheels. You cannot go with three wheels, right? So you have to have a good combination. So that's the fifth thing. The sixth important thing is being social. More than online, you have to be physically social, not physically, I mean socially, interaction with other people, with people outside, talking to people, right? You have to gain that confidence, right? So being more social gives you, your brain, more electrical signals, more synapses. It activates your own sectors of the brain which are physically more relevant. So it's good to act for your brain health in the long term, being more social. And the last but not the least, the big step to actually have a sharp mind, a very, activate your memory and all, is by trying new stuff. Yes, you have to try new stuff. Basically, you have to pursue your intellect. Intellectually, you have to increase yourself by trying new stuff. Obviously, you can do only two things. Either you can do the same thing faster or better, or you can try new stuff. Right, you have to do either of these things by in order to increase your intellect. So that is how you challenge yourself, challenge your intellect regularly. It's not necessary to do brain games and all, although you can play brain games, puzzles and all, or chess and all, but the main objective is to challenge your intellect. Right, you can do that in a daily life also. You can do that in your work, in your studies, in any kind of thing which you do. Just try to do it faster or try to do it better, or try to find out another, you know, new way of doing it faster, something like that. So try new things, right? I'm not asking you to leave your job and try a new job. I'm just telling you to try a new way of doing things. This is important for your brain, so that your brain learns new stuff, so that there are more and more and more of activity in your neurons. And this way you can actually prevent all the brain diseases later in life and have a much, much sharper brain day by day, day by day. And a big important stuff is to be with people. Be with people socially who are having more intelligence, who are intellectually enhanced than you, better than you. Because when you are with people, you actually get influenced by them. Like, for example, if somebody is in a laughing environment, then he is most probably laughing as well. If somebody is with some people who are crying, you might cry as well, right? That's why when somebody yawns in front of you, you also yawn, because brain has that connection with people which is much more than our understandings, and you get influenced by your surrounding. So keep good things in your surrounding, keep positive things in your surrounding, positive people, better people, intelligent things should be seen. Stop watching sad, depressing or sad songs, sad videos. Those will not give a positive feedback to your brain, right? Obviously, the more positive you are, the more you will have a positive impact on your brain. So this is the key. Stay happy, stay focused, stay blessed. And I spend time with your family, meditate, and drink a lot of water. Water is also important. Salt and water balance is important for your brain. So water dehydration is a big factor when it comes to brain also. So make sure to follow all these things. I'm Dr. Paramjeet. Hope you liked the video. Give it a big thumbs up if you did. Share this video to all your friends and colleagues. And I'll see you tomorrow with another video. Take care. See you tomorrow. Bye.